For the first time in nearly a century, a total solar eclipse has crossed over the entire nation from coast to coast. The so-called Path of Totality started in Salem, Oregon, where crowds gathered and looked to the sky in awe. And it continued on through the heart of the country, where the best views lasted about 2.5 minutes. Finally, it passed over Charleston, South Carolina, before crossing out into the Atlantic Ocean. Back in Boston, plenty of people turned out for a view of a partial eclipse. More than 100 people gathered at the Boston Public Library. We were too far north to catch the Path of Totality, so about 63% of the sun was covered here. Still, it was an event to remember.
It's the sun, but it's like a crescent. So the moon is blocking part of it. It's pretty crazy, unbelievable to me that I can actually see this.
It's like two big bites of a cookie, if you want to think of it that way. But yeah, no, it's really cool.
It kind of looks like a really bright half moon.
Yeah?
And, yeah, I guess it kind of looks like a Pac-Man, too.
The last time any portion of the U.S. experienced a solar eclipse was 1979, when the view was visible in the Northwest. This time, scientists were ready and waiting to gather information they can only get during a total solar eclipse, data that could change our understanding of the sun itself and how it affects us here on Earth. That is the subject of a one-hour special airing tonight called Nova Eclipse Over America. And I'm joined now by the senior executive producer of Nova, Paula Apsel. Paula, thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
At a moment where I should note, you are still finalizing this documentary, right? You're going to run out of this interview and wrap it up?
We are. In fact, we are editing in the footage from today. We actually had a whole documentary, 52 minutes made, and now we're changing 8 sections to reflect exactly what happened today. And as you put it, Adam, we are not done yet. So right out of here, I will run up to the edit room and finish my sections.
All right. So extra enthusiastic thanks for taking the time to join us. Why is this total eclipse such a remarkable opportunity for scientists? I had no idea that there was a benefit other than getting to step away from your desk and kill a few minutes staring out the window. But what can scientists do today that they can't do at other times?
Well, the sun is our local star. It really makes all life on Earth possible. But the sun is really still a mystery to us, especially the part of the sun, its atmosphere, called the corona. But the only time that you can see the corona is during a total solar eclipse. It's the atmosphere. It's outside of the sun. But the sun is too bright to see the corona. And the greatest mystery is that the corona, the sun's atmosphere, is actually hotter than the surface of the sun itself. And why should there be? There's just so much we don't understand about the sun. But also, the sun sends out from time to time these great blobs of electromagnetic radiation that come toward Earth, and they can really harm all of our electronics, all of our communications
devices.
And
they come toward us at a terrifying speed, right? 2,000 miles per second, if I remember the documentary correctly?
Absolutely. And they can shut the whole grid down. So what scientists really want is to learn how to predict these CMEs so
coronal
that...
coronal mass ejections.
Right, so that we can be protected. And again, they can only do that because they can only understand the corona itself during a total solar eclipse.
Let me ask you, not to get too esoteric, but you feature in the documentary a group of scientists, I think based in Colorado, who are studying the sun year-round, all day, every day, via satellite. So what can you get from actually looking at the sun, photographing the sun, studying it during an eclipse that you can't get from that sort of satellite study during other points of the year?
Well, satellites are very important, but of course nothing can eclipse an eclipse in importance, because it really is the only time you can see the corona. And by looking at the corona at different exposures and photographing it through a telescope at different exposures, you can really begin to see the kinds of activities related to the very powerful sun's magnetic fields that either can toss off these coronal mass ejections or can otherwise do harm, and also can tell us why the corona is so hot when the surface of the sun, hotter than the surface of the sun, such a mystery.
How hot is the corona, roughly speaking? I think 28, if I remember the documentary right, I was going to say 28 million degrees on the surface.
Well, that sounds really right to me. I'm sorry, that's
right,
a factoid I didn't memorize.
And
that,
it is comprised, if I understand correctly, of plasma, correct?
It is plasma.
Which is, and these are things that if I ever knew them, I'd manage to forget them until seeing your documentary. It's, plasma is gas heated to an incredibly hot temperature.
That's right. And it's a form of matter that we don't naturally see here on Earth. So to really get an opportunity to study a plasma, which is really what the whole sun is made of, is really a huge opportunity. We really want to understand this star that is so important to life on Earth.
So when the eclipse happened, a lot of scientists scrambled into action and tried to gather a whole bunch of information in about 2.5 minutes. But there is an exception, a team that you highlight in the documentary. I think they're based in Houston. Tell me what they were doing with this pair of NASA jets that they were flying during the eclipse.
Well, they can put up two NASA jets, and by staging them exactly correctly as they fly in and out of the path of totality, they can actually get a total of 7 minutes of total eclipse. So that really gives them a lot of time. And there's another scientist, Jay Pasikoff, who's right from Williams College in Williamstown, Massachusetts. And I think he may have seen more total solar eclipses, more solar eclipses, in fact, because there are kinds other than total eclipses, than anyone else, maybe even in the world. This is his, Jay Pasikoff's, 66th eclipse. Yes.
So he's just been globetrotting over the years, I assume, taking these things in?
He has been. He is an expert in solar astronomy, and I would wager knows more about eclipses than anyone else.
Do you have a sense yet, as you work to put this documentary to bed, of how the researchers who were trying to catch the eclipse in action today, whether they got what they were looking for?
No, they will not. It will take them months to process their data. The data, that's why the data is so valuable. It's going to keep them busy for months and even years to come. But I can say that they were very optimistic because all the equipment seemed to be working. So they were really optimistic about getting some really good observations and having a lot to study that's going to give them the kind of understanding that they want of the sun.
So I have to go lowbrow with my final question and ask if you did in fact wear your NOVA-branded safety glasses to look at the eclipse there. Did you cheat and maybe just look directly with the naked eye for a moment?
I absolutely did not look with the naked eye.
And I assume
I'll
not.
Give you, I think they're very fashionable.
Yeah, they are.
We gave out 5,000 pairs of those, and we ran out. I was extremely popular because I had them to hand out.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and they protect people's eyes, and I ran out of the edit room myself with my glasses. And I just have to say, you know, I make science films, but it was just the most fantastic experience, even though we didn't have, we only had 63% here. I don't know about you, Adam, but I thought it was pretty terrific.
It was cooler than I expected. Watching through a window with glasses on, it was still very impressive.
It was
impressive.
Great, yes.
All right, Paula Apsel, thank you for taking the time to join us. Good luck finishing up the documentary.
Thank you very much.
Can I keep these for the next one?
You absolutely may. Seven years till the next one, and we'll make another NOVA on it.
Okay, I love it. Paula Apsel is the senior executive producer of NOVA. You can catch NOVA Eclipse Over America tonight after the president's address to the nation. The president is scheduled to speak at 9 p.m. The NOVA special will begin immediately after.